Good morning, students. Now we are going to solve a cone problem in projection of solids. First, let me read out the question. Draw the projections of a cone base 75 mm diameter and axis 100 mm long lying on the HP on one of its generators with the axis parallel to the VP. So now we look at the given conditions. So first we need to look at the type of solid. It is a cone having the required dimension, diameter and the axis. Next we will look at the resting condition, which is very important for any projection of solid problem. So the resting condition is that the cone is lying on HP. It is lying on HP on one of its generators. So you see the cone is one among the solids of revolution type of solid. It doesn't have any actual edges. So you can take any line which is on the surface of the cone as a generator. So it is lying on any one of its imaginary generators on HP, and the axis should be parallel to VP when it is lying on its generator. So before we go to the actual condition, we need to assume that the cone is initially lying on HP with its base. Initially you assume this, and the axis is perpendicular to HP. Also it will satisfy the condition of parallel to the VP. So first of all, I'm going to assume something. So let me mention the condition. What I'm going to assume, my axis is parallel to VP. So this condition is going to be constant. So now when the cone, as per the given condition, lying on HP on one of its generator, that means the axis will be inclined to HP. So that is what the given condition. So first I am going to start such that the axis is perpendicular. Perpendicular to HP. So first we will consider this assumption. We will draw the front view and top view. Later we will include this particular resting condition. Why we are doing this assumption is, straight away I cannot start drawing this condition. So I am making initial assumption. Gonna draw the front view and the top view. Later I can tilt my views to get the actual line condition. Hope so this is clear. So first you go to line command, draw a line, horizontal line of any length. So we will go 350 and mention some names for this reference line. So x, y, so let us consider this reference line as x, y. Anything above x, y will be my VP and below is my HP. So the front view will lie on VP, above XY, and top view will come. So based upon this condition, axis is parallel to VP and perpendicular. If the axis of my cone is perpendicular to HP, then my cone is lying on its base on HP. Okay. So you know there is a cone. So the axis is perpendicular and parallel to VP. To satisfy this condition, I will take a cone and I will position on HP in such that the base circle of the cone will lie on HP. So HP is below XY, so circle can be seen on lying on HP, which is nothing but your top. Yes, so first draw a circle with diameter 75 mm on HP, satisfying this condition. So I am going to draw a circle of dia 75 and divide the circle into 4 equal parts. Even you can go with 8, 12 equal parts, all depends upon your convenience. So let us name this circle. So when you look from the top, I can see all the points. So I can see A, I can let us name this as B, C, D. So I can see all this point. even this apex also I can see. So nothing is hidden from the top. So next we draw projectors from A, D. So this is a common projector for both P and D. Also from C. Draw projectors. So if you want projectors to be differentiated from other solid line, you can change the color of these projectors. Even these are also imaginary, you can change the color. Nothing wrong with that. Fine. So this is the required top. So now from the axis, so this is the generator from the axis where you will get the maximum height. Since it is a cone and the axis height is 100 mm. So from here, draw a line of 100 mm. Okay. So this is a center line. So first we'll load the center line type, which is ISO4. Okay, so you select this line and you change the line type as ISO4. Okay. So we don't have a solid edge, so I am drawing it as a center. So now I can join this here. Similarly, you can join the apex with the other side and connect it. So this is the required top. Even though we don't have edge for a cone, when you look from the front view, one of its generator will act as a solid edge. So that is the reason I have used a solid line here for the outer surface. Yes. So now we will start mentioning the names. So this apex is nothing but a O dash. And here when you look from the, you imagine you are standing here and you are looking at this circle, you can see the A, you can see B, C. This one D is hidden. So understanding this concept, you mentioned that B dash is visible, D dash is hidden, C dash is visible. Fine, completed. Now we will move on satisfying. So this is generator. Okay, OC is one generator and OE is generator. Similarly, we have OB and OD. They fall, they go inside center axis. They are merging with the axis. Now I need to satisfy the condition. Now the axis is parallel to VP. Yes, that is fine. So this axis is parallel to VP and it is perpendicular to HP. That is also completed. Now we need to satisfy the next condition, lying on HP on one of its generator. So I need to tilt this triangle in such a way that it lies on OC. This OC is lying on this particular X-frame. So for that you select this, you select all these edges along with these notations. Copy them, Control C. So wherever want you can paste them. So now you select all this, group them together. Fine. So now as I mentioned earlier, I want my OC lying on XY. First of all, we will rotate this, but before rotating we don't know the angle between this line and XY. So first of all, we'll try to measure the angle, so between this line and XY. Yes, so the angle is 111 degree, and I have to rotate in clockwise. So we'll see. So I go to rotate, I select the objects, press enter. So I take this as my reference, and when I give 111, you see it rotates in the opposite direction. So I don't want in that direction. So what you do, once again you select, click rotate, same reference, you give -111. Why this is happening is by default AutoCAD will, when you give a value, it will rotate in anti-clockwise, but I need in clockwise, so I am giving this one. Now you see these two lines are parallel to each other, so we can delete this. Now you select this, click move, take this as reference and put on xy line. Zoom it and put it wherever you want, you can put. Yes. Fine. So we have placed the cone exactly on this line. Yes. So now we need to start drawing the projectors. So use this line command. Make sure that the auto is switched on. Start drawing lines from all these four corners. So this is common for A, O, and C. And this is for B. Similarly, you draw projectors from here, then from C. Similarly, from D. Also from that's it. So intersection of O dash this. So this is emerging from O. This is common for A O. So we have O O. So this is my O one. So like that we can identify the remaining points. So this is my O one, and this will be my A one. This will be my B one. This will be my C one. This will be my D one. So this is the required points. So we'll give them the names. So we'll take this as O1. This will be my A1, B1, C1, and D1. Yes. So when you look from the top, this entire line is visible. So that means this entire ellipse. Okay, so this circle will become ellipse because of this inclination. So this entire ellipse will be visible. So we are going to use this ellipse command. Center, first we will select the major axis, then minor axis. Then the generators, the outside generators will be visible, which is nothing but the OD and O. So this is the final answer. So we can select these lines and give a different color and increase the thickness. If you want, you can mention the hidden line also. So OA, since it is a cone, it's generated. So even if you miss out, that's not a problem. It's not a solid edge that we are missing out. It is just a generator. I imagine it one. So I'm selecting the projectors and changing the color so that the actual image pops out. Yes. So this is the final answer. So I hope now it is clear. So this is pushed down. The entire cone is pushed down. So when you look from the top, so this entire ellipse should be. So if this line is hidden, if this two corners are hidden, we need to draw some hidden lines. Okay. Yes. So this is the final answer for this diagram. Thank you.